just want to security back. Yo,
fast bag and beating by the way. Matty Fields, what's up? You the body alive.
I never see you.
Security back, I just want to security back.
That's my money.
Security back, I just want to security back.
Oh, oh, me that.
Security back, I just want to security back. I just want to security back. I just want to security back.
Yeah, me go.
You are not big, eh? You do what you are. I will go to court on play mini. I'm more at the car. And me no fresh, she said, go. Give my dear fruit of my labor. I just want security back. Me right, please do me.
Welcome, welcome, welcome back, guys, beautiful people of the world. Hope you guys are doing extremely well. Your girl Kia Naomi back with another hair video. This is not a detailed video, by the way. This is just me showing you guys how I did my natural hair, how I achieved a faux lock style. This is an individual technique, so this will take you probably days. It took me literally a day and a couple of hours to do. So yeah, keep on watching and I hope you guys enjoy this video. So I'll be using two oils for today's video. I'll be using an argan oil and a serum for both my hair and my scalp, so that way my hair is nice and moisturized along with my scalp, so it doesn't end up too dry over time. I'm going to be using a rubber band for today's video because I do want that really nice tight neat look to my hairstyle as well. So I applied the serum so that way when I'm applying the rubber band onto my hair and also when I'm removing it, when I'm taking it down, it's not going to pull or break my hair. So that's basically it. I'm not going to go into detail on how I section my hair because there's so many videos out there for you guys, and considering I am a beginner just like you guys, so we're not going to go into it. But I'm just basically sectioning my hair and then I'm just going to go in and twist it. Now obviously I did end up plaiting my hair, which took me even more longer to, you know, complete the style. So I would say, just to avoid wasting time, I would say plait your hair and then finish off by twisting it out and all of that good stuff. So yeah, that's basically it. I will say also another thing is that when you're using the rubber band method, the rubber band may show just a little bit, just a tiny bit. So if that doesn't bother you, if that's something that's not going to bother you so much, then you are good to go. Otherwise I would say just, you know, make sure that your parting is nice and neat and you can just plait it and you're good to go. I just use a rubber band because it just makes it easier for me, so that way my, you know, my hair is not looking too raggedy. I do want that neat kind of parting look to it, if that makes sense. So my hair is done. I'm going to go in with a serum and I'm going to apply that onto my scalp so that my scalp is nice and moisturized and it's looking a bit shiny, and it's not too dry and all of that good stuff. So this is the hair that I will be using. You guys will see that later in a bit. The details of the hair will be down below. I bought this from AliExpress. Love this hair. I love the fact that it's not too shiny. I love the color and it's quite coarse as well, so it almost looks like your natural hair, and it also looks like, it almost looks like a dreads-ish, if that makes sense. So that was kind of what I was going for. I wanted it to look a little bit more realistic. And the best part of this hair is that it actually comes with a latch, which is a bonus. Now I bought 6 packs, but I actually ended up using 3 literally, so even better. So yeah, that's that, guys. So I've done most of my hair and this is actually the next day. I done most of these sections. I'm just going to show you guys the last bit. So what I do is I take the hook through my section, my sectioned hair. I'm going to get the hoop of the locks. I'm going to pull that through my hair. And then I'm going to just, you know, get my hair and the locks and I'm going to pull that through the hoop. And I'm only going to knot it once because the hair is pretty coarse. So don't worry so much about it unraveling over time, because it's going to pretty much stay in place. And that is what I love about this hair. Now, I will say it's probably best, unless you're not too bothered, it's probably best to use a hair that kind of mimics your natural hair color. And the reason why I say this is because you will probably see my natural hair was kind of peeping through the locks as well. But since, you know, I wasn't bothered, and plus I really did love the color on me, I wasn't too, you know, I wasn't too bothered about my hair showing just a little bit. So what I'm doing is I'm actually going to unwrap the locks just a little bit. And what I'm going to be doing, following the direction of where the locks falls on, I'm actually just going to wrap that around my natural hair. And I feel like this is the best technique to use, especially if you are a beginner and you struggle to take the latch through the locks and you pull the hair, your natural hair, through the locks. I feel like it's so much effort. I tried doing that first few rounds and I just couldn't do it, guys. So I found this technique online. I was like, I'm gonna give this a go, guys. This is the easiest the easiest technique you can do, and it actually doesn't take that long to do either. I will say it will take longer because obviously this is an individual technique, an individual method. So it took me about, let's say, roughly 4 hours to do the entire head. But I will say this is one of the simplest techniques that I can do for myself, considering this being my first time once again. And what I then do is, when I'm done with, you know, wrapping it around, I will have a bit of hair left just by the tip. So what I do is I kind of pull the locks, not too much, but just pull it enough so that way the tip of my hair is kind of covered and everything is kind of locked in place. You guys can kind of see my hair is kind of showing, my natural hair is kind of showing here, but you know, it didn't bother me as much. That's why I say it's best to probably use a natural colored locks that kind of mimics your natural color hair, if that makes sense. So yes, that's that, guys. I'm going to be using both the olive oil holding spray just to hold everything in place. I'll also be using the Cantu Shea Butter gel, styling gel, as well as the mousse to get rid of any flyaways, to also lock the hairs further, so that way my natural hair doesn't, you know, peek through and it doesn't come out of the locks, considering my hair isn't as thick and as coarse as the locks itself. And also just to get rid of any flyaways and just to make sure that my hair looks as neat as I can get it. So yeah, that's that, guys. And yeah, I'm going to go in, you will see in a bit, I will use a Got To Be gel, and I will apply that onto my edges just to lay those babies. I didn't end up using the gel in the end results, because this was probably a couple of days after doing the style, when I show you guys the end results. I didn't lay my edges, so you guys will see my edges towards the end will look a bit raggedy, but that's because I filmed this, I filmed the results a couple of days after this particular clip right here. So yeah, just a FYI. And voila, guys, this is the end results. I'm going to quickly show you guys how I style the hair and all of that good stuff, but I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sorry guys if it's not like the most detailed video, but this is just me showing you guys how I did the style, considering this was my first time. But if you guys want me to do like a detailed video, let me know. But in the meantime, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Take care, stay blessed, stay safe, and I shall see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.
J'ai sorti les bouts de mie. Moi je voulais commencer mes nuits. J'ai sorti les bouts de mie.
Ce soir on s'enjaille, elle m'a validé.
On dépense en